one innings that I can remember, another opening batsman, Sanat Jayasuriya from Sri Lanka. It wasn't a long time ago. I think it was just perhaps a season or so ago when he made 189 runs of 161 balls. That was a fantastic innings. I thought he would have gone on and gotten 200, actually. I thought he would have definitely had the highest innings in a one-day international. But he got out perhaps because of a little bit of tiredness.
Hello again from Cricket Classics. Today we feature a very special performance from the final of the Sharjah Champions Trophy 2000, Sri Lanka versus India. This match saw record highs and lows for Sharjah, the highest individual score made in Sharjah by Sanat Jayasuriya. Captain Jayasuriya has led from the front with 224 runs and saved his best for the final. After winning the toss, he elected to bat. Here he is about to face the first ball from Zahid Khan.
Zahir Khan with the first ball of this final. And of course, Jayasuriya letting his intentions known immediately. Little swing again, but he played that well, Sanat Jayasuriya. Edged fine again, another boundary.
What a start for Sri Lanka. They'll be delighted with this. 16. Still got one ball left in the second over. This was a lucky one, though. Allowing for a little bit of swing. It didn't swing as much as he anticipated. But it's gone all the way along the ground. So bonus for Sri Lanka.
That's gone over the top. Full and also a bit of width.
Again edged, third man square, and another boundary for Jayasuriya. It bowled in. Zahir Khan has got the wicket. Palu Ritana was looking to blast that off the back foot on the offside. He only manages to get the inside edge, and the ball's gone and hit the off stump. That's well played. A neat deflection from Jayasuriya. Fine leg was up in the circle. Good touch here from the Sri Lankan captain.
That was very clever by Sanat Jayasuriya, realizing that the Indians had got his favorite areas covered, just getting across the stumps and nudging it very, very finely.
As he enjoyed that shot, Indy. He takes the aerial route here. His clear point. And he's found the boundary.
Sanat Jayasuriya is on 41. And Marvin Adapadu has just hit that beautiful floor, that lovely cut shot through the offside field. So he's got himself to 7 now. Quite a lot of batting still to come in the Sri Lankan lineup. They're playing well as a unit. They haven't lost in this tournament as yet. This is probably a good way to look at these two fieldsmen. They're just moving into position now. Sanat Jayasuriya batting here. And, of course, there's the first of the fieldsmen. Let's try that again. There's the first one right there. And the other one right there. So they both sort of in line. Anything is hit up in the air on the onside, and that'll be it. Except if you do it like that. Beautifully played. That's a lovely shot. Down to the boundary for 4. This man is one of the best players of a pull shot in the game today. Lovely cricket. Positive.
It's good cricket. He knows they're going to bowl straight at him. He knows he wants to hit it on the onside. So if he can get inside it, and it's just a little short like it was on this occasion, Jayasuriya just rocks back. He doesn't try and keep it down because there's no fielders there. They're very close. They're only 15 yards from the bat. So anything hit with any sort of power is going to go too fast for them. And he doesn't even try and keep it down. There's no fielder there.
That's 4. That's exactly what Barry Richards was talking about. You cannot pitch the ball outside leg stump. You've got to be very, very careful of a fine leg slip. Oh, have a look at that lovely little dab. just knocking it down to third man. The Sri Lankans on this ground are cheering every single ball. The reason why they've gone up there is because he's now reached his half century. Sanat Jayasuriya is having a ball. 83 for one. Oh, and he's touched it. He's touched it. He wants a replay. What he's saying, now this is very interesting. What he is saying here is that I want to know whether the batsman got back. He's not asking whether he touched it. That has been established. He's not allowed to ask the third umpire whether he touched the ball. So, if he's out of his crease, he's out.
And those are very hard to get back. When you're looking for the run, you know he's hit it powerfully. And this is going to be very touch and go. Is his bat in the air? Is his bat in the air? That's a tough one for Steve Dunn. I think he's gone. I think the bat is down just a fraction too late.
Yes, I think the shadow tells the story here. Watch the shadow. The shadow only comes into play when the bat's on the ground. The ball hits there. And I think you're right, Barry. I think that's the end of that. That's very unlucky.
Definitely.
And, oh, yes, touch the finger as well. Yes, all right. Everything's right. The Indians all think it's a good decision. 90 for two.
தெரிந்த சினிமா மார்க்கெட் அந்தர்ஜாத்திக சினிமா உலக
சுப்புக்கே சுப்புக்கே சபுக்கோ